how do you maximize your TSP options? So again, let's pull the pay stub out. If you'll find with me the box that has TSP data, you'll see that you have either a percentage or a dollar amount that you're contributing to the TSP. This number, if you're a FERS employee, needs to be at least 5% of your pay for you to receive the full match from the TSP. Again, you put in 5, they're putting in 5. And you will see that down further on your pay stub as we look at the deductions line. You'll see how much per pay period is going into TSP savings. Also in that deductions area, if you are doing the catch-up contributions, you'll see TSP CUC. The catch-up provision is for those that are 50 or older. You can put in additional monies beyond the max into the TSP simply because you're approaching retirement. You can save more money that way. So that's the provisions that the 401k laws give us, and the TSP falls in line with that. Just below that, you will see, look a little further on the pay stub, you'll see where the benefits paid by the government for you are listed. This is where you can find 2 lines with TSP. One says TSP Basic. This is the 1% or the piece that they give you for free just for being a federal employee. You get some of that basic contribution to the TSP. And then you'll see TSP Matching. This is where you are making the contribution and they are matching additional percentage. So again, they're giving you 1, they're matching you 4 as long as you put in 5. So their 5% goes in when your 5% is going in. That's the way that match works. So you see that on your pay stub. Everything that you are contributing above their what the TSP is contributing is not being matched. It is just your money being saved inside of this TSP program. So I want to make sure you understand what you are getting and what you are not getting from the government as an employer for you. So now let's look at these basic numbers. So if you are contributing, say, 15% of your salary, let's make that number nice and easy, $16,951. The government contributions for their match for your salary would be $5,669 in this example. That means you are contributing beyond the match per year right about $11,000. Let's now break that down into per pay period. So your contributions per pay period of, say, $651. The government match is $217. That means beyond the match per pay period, you're at $434 per pay period. That is money you're saving that you're not getting a match from the federal government. So you have to ask yourself, what's the purpose of that saving? I know that question may sound a little simplistic, but bear with me for just a moment. Is the purpose for you to use it purely for retirement down the road? That's typically the answer that we receive when asked that question. Sometimes people consider, well, I have other expenses like college funding for children or getting a house paid off more quickly or the vacations that you want to take, all sorts of different answers some people will have. Typically, it's to have more money saved so I can have more income in retirement. If that's the purpose, then is saving the money in the TSP the best and most flexible place for you to save the money? Let's first walk through the best places to have your money when you retire, okay? Number one, we always want to get, in our smart money list, we always want to get the free money that's on the table. Of course, we all would agree that the best kind of money is free money. And you can have that as a FERS employee if you are contributing 5% of your salary to the TSP. The government gives you a full 5% contribution into your TSP as well. Second, we have a tax-free bucket that would be the second best place to pull money from when you retire. I guess when you're retired, it is the best place to pull money from. In tax-free retirements, we talk about 3 different buckets that can potentially be tax-free if managed, handled appropriately. Number one, we want the Roth bucket. With Roth, you have Roth TSP. A lot of good information we've posted out there about how the Roth TSP can work and can benefit you. It is where you put money in after tax, and when you take the money out, it's tax-free. As long as you play by the rules, what you contribute, and the earnings are tax-free in that environment. Okay? Both those are true for the Roth. The Roth TSP, we also have a Roth IRA in existence in America today. So you can place money in a Roth IRA. You don't get a tax break when you put it in. You can have tax-free distributions as long as you play by the rules. It's straightforward. You just have to be old enough and have the account long enough. All the distributions can be tax-free. The purpose today is not to give you all the ins and outs of how a Roth works. I want to make sure you understand it's out there. We have more available information for you on that. A lot of information, actually. We've done several other programs, videos. We have work on the website. The second tax-free bucket can be the cash value of life insurance. This is where, over a long period of time, you place money in a savings inside of an insurance program, and that insurance program can have the potential to grow in cash beyond what you've paid into the program. That gain can be accessed, again, tax-free, just like the Roth, tax-free, using those same words. Again, as long as you play by the rules the IRS lays out. So that is another vehicle that can be used at an earlier age for some folks. You can access your money without having to be over 59 and a half. You can use it for multiple purposes. A lot of good uses for cash value and life insurance for parts of holdings for individuals. It's not my intention today to make any recommendations or for you to act upon the financial advice that I'm talking about, but do examine that. Look into these ways to build assets in that tax-free bucket. We also have municipal bonds. Most of you have most of your money in this tax-deferred bucket. When you look at your pay stub and you see TSP contributions, know that those TSP contributions and the government match are going in a tax-me-later bucket. Tax-deferred means tax-me-later. It doesn't mean no tax. It means the government will give you a break today, and then somewhere down the line, you will pay. And if you don't use it, you pass away, someone else will pay. But there will be taxes paid on that tax-deferred bucket. And so you have to ask yourself, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Sure, it feels good today not to pay taxes right now. How will it be when you get down the road? Will your tax bill be less later? Will tax rates in America go up or down? You need to think about those variables before you decide, well, I'm just going to defer and pay all my taxes later. For most Americans, they typically think I'm going to have less income in retirement, therefore my tax bill will go down. As we work with hundreds of federal employees every year and actually look at what their pensions will be and their other income sources, Social Security, spouse's income, all that stuff, we oftentimes find federal employees not getting into a lower tax bracket. So deferring taxes until later to hopefully save money is often not a reality for the federal employee. Again, I'm not giving advice today in this general audience, but you need to know the answer to that question and determine, is it better for you to continue saving in a tax deferred bucket, or should you be looking at some of the tax-free options in preparation for retiring and moving into the distribution phase of retirement? Lastly, we do have a taxable bucket that we want to mention briefly. That's where you make an earning, earn something in an investment in 1 year. Say it grows 10%, then you have to give up 20% for taxation. So you only made 8. The next year, maybe you make 5. Oh, you only made 4 because you have to pay tax. And every year, you can end up paying taxes on those gains. So be careful of that. That can be very detrimental to a long-term return as well, if not managed appropriately. So look at this smart money list, determine where you are, where is your money now, and can you do things to put it in a better place for long-term retirement? Have this smart money list right up against your pay stub and look at where you're saving your money. Maybe pull out your TSP statement, see the tax qualification of your money in the TSP, and make sure that you are making the right determinations for the withdrawal stage, not the contribution stage, but the wonderful day when you get to retire and draw that money out.